Okay guys, just taking a different direction here with this one. Again, I fell so much in love with all of the music of Carmen. I mean, you just can't help it. You get hooked. I went in with the intention of focusing on one aria, which was the Habanera from last week, but I figured I would talk about the two loves that Carmen had, one of them being Don Jose and Escamillo, the bullfighter. Hi, in today's video, we're gonna break down the story of Don Jose and complete part two of this Carmen mini-series that I have going. I'm so excited and thank you for staying with me. And so in today's video, I'm going to break down where we just came from, which was Carmen deciding whether or not she wants to go off with the smugglers to help them with their contraband. Carmen is like, nah, girl, I can't, because you know what? I need to wait for Don Jose. And they're like, oh my gosh. So they leave, they're like, okay, go ahead. And she actually hears Don Jose singing in the background. She's like, yes, I got him. And he arrives and he also has so much love for her, which I wanted to take a moment and point out that I could see why Carmen, in her deciding whether or not she wanted to take on Don Jose as her lover, actually decided to take him on because he confesses his love to her in the Flower Aria. And so just check out what's coming next. At the bottom of this video, I have the French and then I put the translation underneath it. And so you can read along as you listen to this beautiful aria. And I've chosen an amazing tenor, a world-class tenor who will be remembered for the ages because of his beautiful voice. And that is Franco Corelli. And so maybe I'll go into him more on another day, but I just wanted to share how gorgeous he is in this aria, because he just expresses how that flower that he got from Carmen meant so much to him and completely changed the trajectory of his life. And so we're going to listen to the Flower Aria sung by Franco Corelli. because he's trying to prove his love to Carmen. And I'm sorry, when I hear a man with that beautiful voice singing to me, I'm like, whatever you say, I am totally here for you. I love you too. But Carmen heard him sing his flower aria, basically saying, look at this beautiful flower that you threw at me. I saved it and it gave me strength while I was in detention. And she's like, yeah, but you're not coming away with me, so I don't believe that you really love me. She dances for him and hoping to convince him to come with her to help the smugglers and stay with her and prove his love. And he hears the bell of, while she's dancing this flamenco, he hears the bells of the barracks calling for him to come back home. And he's like, nah, I gotta go. And she's like, oh, you're just not for this. And so then he starts to get upset. He's like, Carmen, I really need to go. And as he goes to the door, he meets his captain, Zuniga, and immediately he just snaps and thinks, well, Zuniga was kind of into Carmen. And Zuniga did say, like, yo, I'm here looking for Carmen. And he just went into a jealous rage and starts to fight him. To fight him, and then the smugglers come back because they hear what's going on. They hold Zuniga down. Don Jose is like laying into him, and that's when he's like, oh my gosh, I have no choice but to leave with Carmen because, one, I want to prove that I love her. Two, I don't want anybody else to have her. And three, I just beat up my, superior officer. There's no way I'm going to come back from that, so I should go. He runs off with the smugglers because he feels like he doesn't have any other choice. We always have a choice. And boom, act three, and we are several months later. We're in the mountains in a hidden encampment that the smugglers, the gypsies, are staying in. And Don Jose is there, and Carmen is there, Fresquita, and Mercedes, and of course other smugglers. But Carmen is really over she's really over Don Jose. He is just getting more jealous. He's young, he's impetuous. He's just like flying off the handle. She can't take it anymore. She's just like, get out of here. Carmen is over this whole, she can't stand him. And so she goes to distract herself with her friends, Fresquita and Mercedes, and they are playing cards. They're looking for their fortunes. They're playing cards and looking to see what their fortunes will be and just having a good time entertaining themselves. And so Carmen takes up in the game and she is trying to look for her future in the cards, and the cards continue to give her the sign of death. It's a great aria. It's called, nicknamed the card aria, where she just has this realization that, okay, I'm going to die, and I think it has something to do with Don Jose, but I'm going to face it head on because I don't know what comes, and I'm confident, and I, will choose to go forward powerfully. So that's what happens. But then we also have in this moment a little background happening. We've got Micaela, who is on her own little secret mission. We haven't heard about her for all of Act 2, but here she appears in Act 3 going, looking for Don Jose at the request of Don Jose's mother, because Don Jose's mother is dying. And Micaela is wanting to fulfill the dying mother's wish to see her son again. And also Micaela loves Don Jose, and she's secretly hoping that he'll just come back with her and just, let go of this crazy life and this crazy way that he's living and return to, these sensible values. And so she's hiding and finding herself. It takes a lot of courage. She sings an amazing aria. It's really hard. Je dis que rien ne me peut vanter. Basically, it's her prayer to God to say, please protect me, please help me through this trial, and that when I face Carmen, I will have, she has beauty and she has Don Jose's love, but I pray that you'll be with me, Señor, Señor, protege me, protect me, so that I can face this. Micaela doesn't know this, and the smugglers don't know this, the gypsy smugglers don't know this, but Escamillo is also in the night, in the mountains, looking for Carmen. He couldn't forget about her, and so he's off there looking for her in his Gaston kind of way.
Gaston, what a pleasant surprise.
But then we see Don Jose, he sees somebody coming, so he lets off a shot into the dark, and Escamillo comes out right away. He's like, hey dude, yo, it's me. Hey, I'm Escamillo, the bullfighter. And at first, Don Jose is like, yeah, I know who you are. You're so cool. And he's like, so what are you doing here? And Escamilla is like, I'm looking for Carmen because she's my next lover. And then he is immediately angry. He starts to fight Escamilla, and then people come in and they try to like pull them apart and they're ready to fight. There's just so much tension. And then all of a sudden in the middle of that, Micaela hears the commotion. She's found and she's like, Don Jose. And he goes like, oh my gosh, what are you doing here? And he kind of like comes back to his senses, but not enough to overcome his anger at Escamillo and at Carmen. He's just like so angry. But what brings him back to reality is that Micaela says, hey, your mom's gonna die soon. You have to come home. And so he basically says to Carmen, this is not the end of me. You're gonna see me again. He leaves with Micaela, but in the background, you hear the Toreador singing. So it gives you a sense that Carmen is gonna get together with that Toreador. All right, and that brings us to Act Four. We're back in Seville, we're in a square. We see a crowd gathering for Escamillo because there's gonna be another bullfight. And Carmen is with Escamillo and they sing of their love for each other. It's very clear that they got together. And then Escamillo leaves Carmen and he enters the bull ring with all the people cheering. And then Frasquita and Mercedes warn Carmen. They're like, hey, we heard word that Don Jose is like nearby. He's not looking so good. And Carmen is like, look, I'm not afraid of anybody. I'm gonna face him. He's gonna have to deal with it. She sees Don Jose and she goes right up to him. She doesn't hold back. And Don Jose, in his inward insanity, really, because it's so clear she's moved on for him. It's clear she doesn't want anything else to do with him. And even in the mountains, she's like, yeah, go back home to your mama. You know, like she makes fun of him, mocks him as he goes. I'm sure his mother passed away and Micaela is clearly not with him because all he could think about was Carmen, even if it was deluded and he had a total opportunity to just start a new life and start over. In fact, Carmen told him, like, just go. That's who you really are. You know, you're not made to be with me. And so he's desperate. He's begging her, please return to me. I can't live without you. She's like, yeah, no, I'm done with you. She refuses him and he begs and pleads one more time. And she again. And she really lets him know that she's done with him by taking the ring that he gave her and she throws it at him and he just loses his and he basically runs up and stabs the poor woman. And then he's crying over her body. He's so crazed by his obsession with Carmen. The crowd comes and they see what's happened and he doesn't even deny it. He's like, I killed her. It was me. And the opera ends just like that. Oh! right, that's my share for today. Thank you so much for watching. Please remember to like this video if you like this video. And please leave me a comment. I love to read what you guys have to say. It makes me feel good to know that there's actually people on the other side of this video. And please remember to subscribe and maybe even hit that little bell so that you know when I'm dropping my next video. This is Cassandra with Opera for Black Folks, serving culture to all folks. And I'm so glad that you are here watching with me. See you guys next week. Ciao.